Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Yogalibrium. My name is Heather, and today this class is a full-length, one-hour-long yin yoga sequence for deep release and relaxation. We're going to be holding all of our poses today between 3 and 5 minutes so that you have plenty of time to sink into the posture and relax. Keeping in mind, in yin yoga, we're looking for 3 different things. The first is to find your edge. Second is to find stillness. And the third is simply to surrender. We're going to go ahead and get started standing at the back of the mat. And bring your feet about hip-width distance apart. Press the soles of your feet into the floor. Take a deep inhale and reach up towards the sky. And then exhale as you fold forward, giving your head a shake. And going ahead and finding opposite elbows. As we stay here in our dangling forward fold, feeling your feet supported on the floor. Allowing your torso and your upper body to relax with gravity. And simply tuning into the awareness of your breath as it flows effortlessly in and out of your lungs. That your mind and your thoughts are beginning to wander beyond your mat. Just tune your attention back to your breath. And tune your awareness to the sensations you experience in your body. Be here now. Thank you. ahead and take one more deep inhale here. Exhale to release. You can slowly release your hands towards the mat. I want you to take your gaze up and go ahead and walk your hands forward along your mat. We're going to move into a wide-legged downward dog. So go ahead and step your feet nice and wide outside your mat. You can crawl your hands in a couple of inches and take your hands wider than you normally would for downward-facing dog. Pull in through your low belly and go ahead and allow your chest and your head to sink down towards your mat. So your heart is relaxing. You feel this deep into your shoulders. And this pose has a little bit more yang energy than we usually use in yin yoga. So if you feel like this is a little bit much for you to hold for a long period of time, I invite you to instead take melting heart pose. So you might go ahead and drop your knees down towards the mat, keeping your hips stacked roughly over top of your knees, crawl the hands forward and allow your heart and your chest and your forehead to melt towards the floor. So either variation here is going to give you enormous benefit. Choosing the one that feels right for you. Thank you. beautiful job. We're gonna go ahead and release out of this pose. So if you're in your wide-legged down dog, bring your feet back towards center and drop your knees. And if you're in melting heart, you're gonna crawl your hands back up on top of the mat. We're gonna go ahead and tuck the toes behind us and sink the hips back over top of the heels, coming into this toe squat. Might be a nice idea to release that energy from your wrists by waving them from side to side and giving them maybe a little shake out. And then feeling yourself breathing, you can relax your hands in your lap and surrender to stillness. And remembering that everything passes, so if this feels incredibly intense for you, just know that that's normal. Doing your best to breathe through the sensations. And we're only going to be here for a couple of minutes. And the last few breaths where you are. Nicely done. You can walk the hands forward and release those toes. Give them a nice tap out behind you. And let's come into child's pose. So taking your toes together and your knees nice and wide. Sink your hips back over your heels. Release your forehead down towards the earth. And filling up the back space of your lungs with your breath. Thank you. from here, you're going to come into rabbit pose. So draw your knees a little bit closer towards each other and reach your hands back to catch your heels, tucking your forehead and the top of your head as close as possible towards your knees. We're going to slowly lift the hips and round throughout the spine. Breathing deeply into the space between your shoulder blades and the entire backside of your body here. Go ahead and release your hips all the way back on top of your heels. Taking your gaze forward and slide your hands up along the mat. Bring yourself up into tabletop and just move through a few cat-cows here in your own pace. Forward onto our bellies. I want you to extend your right arm out beside you so that your hand is in line with your shoulder. Bend your left knee, press onto your left fingertips, and go ahead and take that left leg up and around so that you roll on top of your right shoulder. You can keep the left hand supporting you in front, or maybe wrap it around behind your back and tuck it into your waist. Allowing your breath to be as effortless as possible. one more full inhale. And at the bottom of the exhale, if you have that hand wrapped around behind your back, go ahead and release it back out onto the mat in front of you. And then slowly bring your body back towards center. Be lifting up into a little cobra here, releasing back down. Let's switch sides, extending your left arm out this time. Right knee bends, press into the fingers, and roll over onto that shoulder. Let's go ahead and release this side by bringing the arm in front of you, rolling back towards center. Lift yourself again up through a cobra pose and then back down. And from here, we're going to come into Sphinx pose. So I want you to stack your elbows underneath your shoulders, bringing your hands in front of you with your fingers spread wide. Imagining that you are drawing your heart forward between your arms. Opening up through your heart center. And breathing into your spine. Thank you. you can feel free to stay exactly where you are. It may be an option for some of you if you wanted to move into seal pose, to take the hands a little bit wider, and then straighten out through your elbows. Nice job. Let's release this one. And dropping back down into Sphinx. From Sphinx, releasing all the way down towards the floor. And taking a moment here. And then let's press into the hands and send the hips back. Into child's pose. And on your next inhale, bringing yourself forward, crawl your knees up towards the front of the mat. Take the knees wide again and the toes together. And we're gonna come into saddle pose here. So we're gonna start by walking the hands back first and leaning back to breathe into the front of the body. If this feels like enough, you're gonna stay right here. If you feel like you have a little bit more space, try lowering down onto your elbows. You can keep the chin tucking towards your chest. Release your head back if it feels comfortable. If you feel like you have even more space, you can try lowering all the way down towards the floor. Maybe taking your arms up above your head and taking opposite elbows. And wherever you find yourself, breathing deeply and surrendering to the posture. Thank you. taking your last breath where you are. And we're gonna slowly start to release out of this posture. So taking your time to come all the way back up from wherever you are. And then draw your knees together towards each other. And simply swing your legs out in front of you. And let's move into caterpillar as a counter for our last pose. Reaching your arms up to the sky, take a deep breath in, and exhale, folding forward. And if it helps, bend your knees, allow your spine to round, allow your head to fall towards your knees. Allowing your belly and your chest to relax. And let this be as passive as possible. We're only going to be here for about a minute. And on your next inhale, slowly unraveling yourself to sit back up. Shrug your shoulders back. Beautiful. And I think Remy's going to join me for the next pose. I want you to stay facing the front of your mat. I'm just going to turn around so that I can face you. We're coming into our cow face pose. So go ahead and take your left heel towards your right hip. And then your right heel towards your left hip. So we're roughly stacking the right knee on top of the left. It's not going to be a perfect stack. You're going to take your left arm up and bend the elbow. And then wrap the right arm around behind your back. See if you can reach your fingertips towards each other. And feeling like your sit bones are really rooting into your mat. Feel yourself getting taller and breathing through the center of your body. Relaxing as much as possible as you release through your shoulders and through your hips. Nice, and let's release this side. You can extend your arms open and draw the right arm across your chest, pulling it in towards you. And then we'll go ahead and take the hands behind us as we extend the legs out towards straight. Give them a little shake out from side to side. And then tuck that right heel towards the left hip. Stack your left knee roughly on top of your right knee. Reach the left arm around behind your back and the right arm up towards the sky. Maybe fingertips will reach each other, maybe they won't. It doesn't matter either way. Finding this release through your shoulders. Deep breath in, and then as you exhale, extending the arms out and bring that left arm across your chest, releasing your legs back out in front of you, and once again give them a little shake from side to side. We're going to come into butterfly pose, so drawing the soles of your feet together and connecting your heels as close in towards your pubic bone as possible. Roll your shoulders back, deep breath in, and exhale, bringing yourself forward as much as possible to meet your edge. And relax and release. Thank you. on your next inhale, nice and slow, beginning to come all the way back up. And beautiful. Bringing the knees together, extend the legs out in front of you. And go ahead and lie down on your back. Make sure you don't squish your bunny on the way down. And from here, we're going to set up banana asana. So folding your knees in, press into your feet and float the hips over towards the left side of your mat. Moving your torso and your feet over towards the right side of your mat. It might be an option to hook the left ankle over top of the right and taking your right hand to grab your left wrist. And breathing into that left side of your body. And gently from here, we're gonna switch sides. So go ahead and bring yourself back in towards the center, shifting your hips all the way over to the right, your torso and your legs over to the left. And relaxing and breathing deeply. And then gently, in your own time, we'll release out of that side. And go ahead and hug your knees in towards your chest. And you could roll on your sacrum a little bit from side to side here. I have one last pose for you, and that is happy baby pose. You can catch the back of your thighs, your calves, or maybe your feet if they are available. And drawing your knees down towards the floor. If you wanted to, for a moment, maybe gently rock from side to side. And then find stillness in this last posture of class. Gently starting to release your feet and your knees back towards your chest. And again, taking a few circles on your sacrum in either direction. And wrapping your arms around your legs, bringing your forehead towards your knees, giving yourself one more squeeze. And then exhaling, releasing your legs long and resting your arms towards the floor as we make our way into Shavasana. And completely surrendering here as you melt into your mat for these last few minutes of class. Thank you. and deepening your breath, and gently wiggling your fingers and your toes, rolling your wrists and your ankles. Go ahead and float your arms above your head, bring your legs together, and take one last long, full, deep stretch here before rolling over onto one side and pausing for a moment. And then slowly, in your time, coming all the way up to a comfortable seated position. And as you feel your sit bones rooting into the mat, feeling your spine lengthen, feeling the crown of your head moving towards the sky, go ahead and draw your hands in front of your heart. Bow your chin to your chest. And to end our class, let's rub our palms together, generate some heat between our hands. Place them over top of closed eyes. Inhale. And exhale to let it go. And that's our practice today. Thank you so much for joining me. I truly appreciate your energy and being here in this class. And if you liked this video, please go ahead and show your support by liking, commenting, and subscribing to the channel for more classes just like this. And thank you again. Namaste.